Hi, I'm Julie from JulieTalk.com. You are watching the drama queen, Uncle Mike on The Uncle Mike Show. You can tune in on www.theunclehood.com.
The autumn wind is a pirate, blustering in from sea. With a rollicking song, he sweeps along, swaggering boisterously. His face is weather-beaten. He wears a hooded sash, with a silver hat about his head, and a bristling black mustache. He growls as he storms the country, a villain big and bold. And these all shake and quiver and quake as he robs them of their gold. The autumn wind is a raider, pillaging just for fun. He'll knock you round and upside down and laugh when he's conquered and won. The autumn wind is a pirate, blustering in from sea. With a rollicking song, he sweeps along, swaggering boisterously. His face is weather-beaten. He wears a hooded sash, with a silver hat about his head.
What's crack-a-lackin', Uncle Hood? Welcome back, baby! Welcome back! Hashtag Women's Month on Tums is just cruising along. www.theunclehood.com, Wednesday, October 8th, 1937 hours, baby. Right here in the beautiful, brand new Uncle Hood studio. We have another unbelievable program in front of us, but we cannot move forward until we don't give props to last week's guest. October 1st was the first guest that we got in studio, women, and it was the beautiful ring girl, Mary Pearl. She just blew the entire hinges off the roof. Now it's just for us to make sure we take that entire momentum and carry it through the entire month. There are a lot of talented, beautiful, gorgeous, I don't know what else word I could use, but I gotta use a lot of them because we have a lot of beautiful women coming in studio. Before we start dissecting each one of those programs, I want to just remind you that you could get along with the program on various social media outlets. On Twitter and Instagram, it's at Official Tums. And if you get on Facebook.com/The Uncle Mike Show. We told you that we're trying to put, after 250 programs with absolutely no guideline, with absolutely no script. Well, basically, Uncle Dirty always try to implement one, but for some reason or another, it never got done. But now we started to realize, if we want to go over this new hump, we're going to try to get in order. For that, we hired a couple of new mini-me's. I don't know what's up with Uncle Dirty and these mini-me's. There's just like a half a dozen of them in the studio. But it's so cool to see. One of them is trying to print. One of them is trying to do a fax. One of them is trying to scan. It's just ballistic out there. And then you have Teflon Don sitting right in the middle. Uncle Dirty Dirt, baby. If you've never met him, you're so lucky, man. You're so lucky. Always here, 250 plus episodes. Without him, none of these behind-the-scenes activities would get done. All these Tums Mobiles that we've been so blessed to be a part of, these are the guys that do it. The Suits and hashtag SEC, baby. The Southeast Corner. Now, what we're trying to do for the new upcoming programs, the first 7-8 minutes, try to vent as much as possible and then have a very civil, very diplomatic conversation, a one-on-one, hashtag I ask questions for a living. As you notice, tonight's program, we started with the Autumn Wind is a Raider. Reason why, 3 years ago today, we lost the true Raider of them all, Mr. Al Davis. If you are in the Raider Nation, if you support the Silver and Black, if you have any recollection of regular football, you know that the name Al Davis and the name NFL go hand in hand. He was the black sheep. They used to love picking on him. He was a creative mind that brought in all those minorities. Who's the one that opened the doors? The Oakland Raiders. But most importantly, Mr. Al Davis. I had the privilege, the honor to meet him in 2009. And yes, guys, I fucking met him. I opened the door for him and he passed by right in front of me. As he was passing, I said, the legend himself just passed in front of me. Someone just shoot me now. I've done everything I can. Willie Brown, legendary Hall of Fame, Oakland Raider, turned around, pointed at me and said, that's a true Raider right there. Goosebumps going down by down my spine. When my wife and daughter were in studio, my wife told you the way we met was because of the Silver and Black. They say a family that watches Raider football together goes through a lot of motherfucking stuff together. www.theunclehood.com. Half my heart is dedicated to the Silver and Black, and half my heart is dedicated to Liverpool. 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 And tonight's little rant comes completely off the pitch. And that's the way you guys know this program's foundation is sitting on. Yes, we enjoy the game, but we rather talk about what happens outside the game. Imagine a 103-year-old Liverpudlian by the name of Barry Musker. 103 years old. Sitting in a hospital bed with a bunch of doctors around. And at 103 years old, my man, you can talk from the minute you wake up until you sleep, and nobody has the authority or the right to tell you to shut up. So this lady was going on and on about her 103-year life, and she's seen it all and yada, yada, yada. And then she says something pretty spectacular. She goes, I would have loved to receive a birthday card for my 103rd. But the problem is, she goes, everybody I know is dead. So one of the doctors overhears this and knows that this the beautiful Betty, and wow, what a beautiful woman, at 103 years old, she looks like, without exaggeration, 28. I'm not even lying, guys. I'm not even lying. That's how Liverpool fans are, baby. Betty, you're a darling. I can't believe this, but what a beautiful story. Let's get back to it. The doctor knows that this is a Liverpool fan, goes on Facebook, goes on Twitter, goes on Instagram, and all on of Liverpool's pages, starts to write the story about this 103-year-old Liverpool fan that has nobody to send her a birthday card. Next thing you know, my man, when we tell you, you will never walk alone. Well, Betty, sweetheart, you will never walk alone. There was over 4,500 cards that started to flood into this freaking hospital within the hour of the first original post. The story got so big, ESPN jumped on it. Bleacher Report jumped on it. That's when I knew that off-the-field stories like this reminds us that we're all human. There are so many cards that were sent from non-Liverpool fans and signed Manchester City supporter, but you will never walk alone. This is when you start putting things into perspective, but then you take two steps back, go across the seas on the other side of the world, and they can't even sleep without a few bombs going off here and there. Here in beautiful Montreal, Quebec, Canada, the October season means only one thing. The Montreal Canadiens are back on the tube. But personally, I don't care, man. I'm not a huge fan of the Montreal Canadiens, but we have a lot of Unclehood members that support the Habs like a religion. It is now 1-1. They are playing against those pesky Toronto Maple Leafs. Every time I say the word Toronto Maple Leafs, I could see the southeast corner just shakes just a little bit. Uncle Dirty despises two things. The Turkish race and the Toronto Maple Leafs. That's it. That's it. That's all. Hashtag Women's Month on Tums. What is it? What does it represent? For the first 3 years, this being the third, we always dedicated the Breast Cancer Month to women, and we implicated women into the program as much as possible. We have the Coast to Coast, which is going to be a woman. We have two breaks. That means two musical breaks. That means two musical artists. We bring in guests to go toe-to-toe. Well, you guessed it. Every single one of the guests in the month of October happen to be beautiful, talented women. Now, we come to tonight's program. Now, you guys might be wondering, what's going on? He's done this a million times. Why is he a little nervous? Well, let me tell you. Before the program started, the Southeast Corner called me into a very important meeting. I've never had one of those before. So I walk in, I'm wondering what the hell is going on. And then they tell me, don't forget, our main sponsor, 57 Cals, will be your guest this afternoon. I said, yeah, I know, but why you? Please make sure everything is diplomatic. I said, man, get the fuck out of here, man. We're going to have a good time. I love this girl. She is now sitting in the studio. The lovely and talented Tamar Panossian. What's happening, sweetheart?
Hi.
Whoa, hi.
That
well,
was
hi.
Quite an intro.
You like it? Did you like it at least?
Loved it.
Good. How are you? Finally, we get you in studio.
Good. Thank you so much. I'm honored to be here.
Of course, we were very happy when we heard Uncle Dirty send us the memo to the entire Uncle Mike Show staff saying that we've booked the second guest, which is Tamar Panossian, VP of Operation at Allagma Technologies, co-owner of 57 Cals, and of course, a very talented singer, which we're going to get into in the third segment, because that's where we like to have fun.
Okay.
Before we start getting forward into the program, a lot of people from coast to coast, LA to Chicago, we heard we have a couple of Armenian folks joining us from the beautiful state of Illinois. Welcome. Thank you very much for allowing us entrance into your humble estate. Now look inside this camera and give us a quick little 411. Who's Tamar? Where does she come from and what does she represent?
Who is Tamar? Tamar is a 29-year-old, very ambitious, very patient person who loves life, who loves people, loves meeting new people, loves to be challenged, loves taking on new challenges. As you already introduced, I am in the business world. I love the business world, love the corporate world. I am VP of Operations at Allagma, which is an IT company, IT services company. And I co-own 57 Cals, which is very new. It's been 7 months that we have 57 Cals.
A new journey.
New journey. It's very exciting, very happy to have our little baby, I guess.
When we started to think about the direction of Women's Month on Tums, we wanted to get the entertainment aspect of women in the corporate world, which we got Mary Pearl week one. And then we wanted to learn a little bit about that savvy, business-minded corporate women. And we said, who better than someone that from 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. is on her feet, just going from first project to the second.
Yeah.
And the first name that came to mind was Tamar Panossian. And we were very, very fortunate that you accepted.
Absolutely.
Because apparently we had to go through lawyers and first meeting, second meeting, first set of questions. No, we don't accept. You know,
no.
Joke if Auntie Julie from Julie Talk Live, which airs every Thursday night at 10:30 p.m. right here, www.theunclehood.com. Are you a sports fan, Tam?
when the Habs are winning, absolutely.
Oh, but I love the way she puts it out there.
Uncle
I'm
Harry.
A bandwagon jumper, simple as that. If we're winning, go Habs, go.
Heck yes.
Do you play sports, though? Do you enjoy sports? Do you activities, stuff like that?
I don't have the time to play sports. I used to. I love soccer.
Okay.
I love watching soccer
nice.
Finals. I used to dance Armenian folkloric dance.
Same here.
You did?
Yes. Awesome. Look, I don't want to be patting myself on the back, but Ani Barakhump, first tier that started here in Montreal, yours truly was on it. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
That's all I'm saying. FPF, the first eight. We were dead, Wolverines. That's all I'm saying. That's how motherfucking old I am, goddammit. Uncle Dirty Man. Enough bringing me guests, bro. Half my freaking age, bro. Bring at least the same level so we could talk old school music, man. www.theuncle.com. This is the Uncle Mike Show. We have the beautiful and talented Tamar Panossian in studio. Hobbies.
Hobbies. I love to sing, obviously. You already introduced it. It's my passion. I've been singing for a long time now. Aside from that, hobbies would include sculpting. I just started sculpting.
Whoa, something new. I like the way that you're always jumping into something so out of left field.
I know, right?
But everything I've seen, because I've heard you sing. My wife was at one of your events. Mm-hmm. She had videotaped it. And I told you, I had a semi-crush on her. I didn't know she was from Montreal. I thought she was a singer, like Hollywood superstar. Next thing, my wife goes, you remember that song I told you, sweetheart? I go, yeah, well, that's her. I go, what the fuck? What the fuck? My beautiful voice.
Thank you.
And how long has that been on? Have you?
My singing?
When you were a kid, did you think one day you would be?
Absolutely.
Really?
Absolutely. I've performed countless concerts in front of my mirror in my home since I was young. Professionally, I started taking lessons since 2003. I used to take private lessons. Recently, I was looking into courses with Berklee, a school of music. I love their classes, and I hope I could take a full session with them next year. So I've been singing since 2003. That story is a little original, I guess.
Well, that's what we love. Originality. Baby.
Heck yes. I thought we were doing this in the third section, but if you want me to go on with this,
keep it. Hey, wait a minute. Wait. Whoa. Whoops. There goes gravity, baby. This is a little secret for you. You want to talk about the music? Stick around until the third freaking segment, goddammit. If not, no problem. You could get off now, F this, F that. Tomorrow it's archived, bro. You can get back and see the whole thing with no interruption. The Southeast Corner changing this, that. You don't hear nothing. It's just you. The screen and the lovely Tamar. Before we go on break, I have one question to ask you. I'm going to try to generalize it. I don't know how quick of an answer you can give, but in the corporate world, is it easier or harder for a woman to achieve greatness?
That is an interesting question.
Should we keep it for the second? Maybe we give them a double whammy, we call that, bro. The Southeast Corner is not appreciating this whatsoever because now they're getting emails. I can't believe your host is saying this. I can't, and he can't do nothing. Look at him. Can you see the smoke coming out?
Yes,
I love
can.
It, man. Too bad there is no camera, man. That's what we should do. We got to talk to the I-team.
Uh-huh.
Tell him when he's not here, put one, but don't tell us
you
where.
You surely can.
And then we could put him on the blooper reel and see who gets the last laugh. www.theuncle.com. I want you to answer that question before we go.
Absolutely. First, let me say that my background was not in IT when I did get into Allagma Technologies. However, because I went in as project manager and slowly worked my way up, it was very hard at the beginning to get the respect of not all, I won't say all, some of the IT staff that we had because of their cultural background, because I was a young lady trying to tell them what to do and what not to do and to manage their tasks. So yes, it was hard. But comparing to what times were and now, obviously there's a big difference and it is easier for women to get into the corporate world, definitely.
www.theunclehood.com. Guys, don't go too far. What we're about to do, go pay some bills. Like we said, this is Women's Month on Tums. All the music that we hear is going to be women singers and writers or composers or whatnot. And we are multicultural, so you might hear some Armenian, some Greek, some Italian. And don't lose your patience, don't lose your cool. Like I said, there's all kinds of Unclehood members. We have IP addresses that have came in over 39 countries. For every single one of you, I want to say thank you very much. Let's continue this little emotion reaction that we've started and see how far it can go. Great guests like Tamar tonight. I'm sure that there is a lot more coming on the second and third segments of tonight's program. Before we go there, don't forget, tonight, 9:30 p.m., the John K. Show with host John Kakoulakis and his sidekick. I call him the sixth man. Now we got to refer to him as starting lineup, Mr. Sixth Man. Hickory dickory dock, baby, baby. Every single one of the women in my life, for some reason, bro, I don't know, I can't get one just to be on my side. Let me know when, huh? Check, check. He did it again. Hi, guys. Welcome back. I'm Uncle Mike, and I just got whooped again. www.theunclemikeshow.com is brought to you by 57cals.com. 57cals' vision is to bring the traditional Middle Eastern street food to another level by offering customers an exciting variety of authentic and new versions of fresh and tasty falafel dishes, as well as tofu-based dishes full of color, texture, and flavor. Our dishes are vegan and vegetarian, and our falafels are gluten-free. We strive to make 57 cals above your average fast food restaurant by serving healthy, fresh, and nutritious menu items. www.57cals.com. How did I do? Okay.
Good. Yeah. I can't get used to this.
This is ridiculous. I've never had to pay a bill with the sponsor sitting right in front of me. Every single word looked blurry. I had to focus 10 times more. This is how we do it. Thank you very much for 57 Cals to be on board with the Uncle Mike Show. We appreciate everything you've done for us. Now, the first question I want to ask you is, why did you decide to go in the restoration industry?
Cool. Well, it's very different from my 9-to-5, that's for sure. But to put some rumors to rest, yes, we are the old Crazy Falafel Laval, which was owned by my mother. And for many different reasons, she wanted to change the concept of the restaurant. And because the concept that she wanted to change to was very interesting to myself and to my uncle, we decided to partner with her in this new venture, I guess. And why we changed the concept is because we, in our everyday lives, we started being more socially conscious and more healthy. And in general, we have reduced our meat consumption very much. Myself, I only eat fish or chicken twice a week, I would say.
Same. The rest of the time is vegan.
Vegan. Well, not vegan, vegetarian.
Okay. Before you continue, because now you're telling us why we changed from the Crazy Falafel to 57. Mm-hmm. But I want to know, why did you guys decide to get into the vegetarian / vegan industry instead of your regular restaurant that has a lot bigger consumer base, I guess I could call it?
Okay. I get where you're going. We still have a lot of customers coming in and saying, why did you change your menu? We want meat. Where is the meat? So as I was saying, it's just a conscious decision of healthier choices and reducing our consumption of meat. And we cherish animals. So for us, reducing meat means caring for animals and stopping the torture of animals and stopping the killing of animals. And if we each... I'm not telling people to stop eating meat. I know I will get emails about it later as well. But if we just reduce it, we could make such a difference for the environment. So why not do it? You know, people hear vegan or vegetarian and they're like, no, what is that?
That's so different. Oh, that's where I was. Guys, let's not kid ourselves. If you remember when Uncle Dirty gave us the memo that we have a new sponsor on board, our main sponsor, www.57cals.com, I asked him, I go, 57 Cals, what's going on? He goes, it's a vegan restaurant. I go, from all the restaurants in the fucking world, you went with a vegan restaurant? Please elaborate. He took me to 57 Cal's. We sat down. The beautiful Tamar came outside. And I started trembling, guys. I've been in fist fights with guys 6'6". Yes, I did get whooped, but that's not the point. But I stood there. Here, I was trembling like a freaking leaf. Why? The word vegan terrorized me. And that's how I walked into the restaurant. And this is the truth. I'm not trying to sugarcoat it so we could get more hits. We're going to get the hits regardless because we have a talented woman in the house. Baby, baby. Not because of me or Uncle Dirty's clicking of buttons. Beautiful girl in studio. Clicks will come. It's just inevitable. So I'm sitting down and I'm looking at this menu. But then I realize something. All my life, I've ate falafels. Now, do I see myself eating falafels on a daily basis and cut out meat completely? I doubt it because I love steak. I've grew up with it. And I don't think by me eating the meat, I'm hurting the animals. Because since way back when, hunting has been around. Humans and hunting have been going on and on because we have to eat. We've realized that it's a way of eating. Now, yes, 2014, like you said, a lot of people think of health. A lot of people think of the cruelty to animals. Mm-hmm. A lot of people think of a new way to go. It's very tasty. It's something that you could implement into your diet or into your daily activity. But to completely change it from one to the other, is it possible? Has it been done? And how hard is it to do so?
You know what? Everything that you change, you cannot change from one day to the next. It's a matter of habit. And it's a matter of what you believe in. I myself stopped eating red meat completely. I did not like the taste anymore. In my case, it was different. I did not want to eat it anymore. Plus the documentaries that I've seen and all.
So do you think that's what it was? You read about it and you maybe distanced yourself from it, knowing all these goods that would come from it if you do so?
Absolutely. When you see all the good, as you said, that comes from it, absolutely. It's part of the decision. It's a conscious decision of not eating meat anymore. I wish I could stop eating chicken and fish as well, but and I hope my dad isn't watching, but since he's the cook at the house, and he's got that Middle Eastern mentality, and if there's no meat on the table, then that's not a meal, so...
I grew up with that same mentality. Amo, exactly. I love you, man. Kebab, man. How could you do kebab with vegan stuff? You can't. Or maybe you can.
Of course you can.
You see?
Exactly.
There you go. Yeah. There you go. Let's open up a new can of worms for you. But before we get into that, I want you to give me an explanation. What is the difference between vegan and vegetarian?
Okay.
I received a few emails that they didn't understand what the... And both emails, Mary and Lisa, one from Pennsylvania and one from Lachine, both of them wanted a little bit more of an explanation on the difference between one and another.
Sure. In very simple terms, a vegetarian person will not eat any product which requires the animal to be sacrificed for it. They'll still eat cheese, they'll drink milk, they'll eat eggs, but they will not eat meat. Vegans will not eat any animal product, so no cheese, no milk, no eggs. I can see your eyes. And
whoa. Okay, I consider myself vegetarian from time to time. Vegan, are you effing kidding me, man?
Well,
what do you mean?
Let me give you an example. When you eat mujahedera at home, that's completely vegan.
Yeah,
hello. When you eat full, that's
the amount of times
vegan
that I've ate mujahedera. Zero.
It's lentils.
The amount of time I've ate full, 100 million times. And that shiznit is good. Let's not kid ourselves. But you know what? Coming from an Armenian culture and going to high school, getting new friends. Mm-hmm. We call them odars, right?
Yeah.
Odars. What do you say? How do you say odar in English, man?
Stranger.
Not stranger. Stranger?
Stranger.
Yeah, strangers. You know, new friends, new cultures, whatever. And they're coming over. And one time we had a sleepover the night before, Friday night, and Saturday morning, we had our customary full pacha and shit. Now we have our friends that wake up. One is Kinezo, one is Italian, one is Greek, the other's Arab. We all wake up. Then they're expecting, you know, your regular egg, bacon, sausage, maybe bowl of cereal. You want to go too easy, great. Put Special K and cornflakes together. That's as weird as they'll get. And then we took out the pacha. And they're looking at it. What the fuck is that?
For Mike? Breakfast.
I go, yeah. I go, wait, let me tell you exactly what it is, bro. It's delicious. First thing you have in there is cow's tongue. I saw one guy started to go fucking like, what the fuck is Mike? Exactly. What the? Are we going to eat anything, bro? There's a deli across the street. He goes, let's just go visit there for a second. But I appreciate the way vegans stick to the cause. Mm-hmm. It's became a community, and you said it. Mm-hmm. It's growing.
Absolutely.
Every time I sometimes... since our affiliation with Unclehood Studio and 57 Cals, I do hashtag vegan a lot more. And there's a lot of celebrities. There's a lot of natural athletes. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people that are vegan. And when you look at their physique, you can't tell that they're not eating meat. They're not. So if there's, would you try to convince someone to go vegan? Or is this a personal decision?
You can't convince anybody to do something they don't want to do, that's for sure.
You got to tell that to my wife, man. Somebody tell that memo to my wife.
It's a conscious decision that somebody has to make. They have to believe in it, and they have to make the change. So, and to come back to what you were saying earlier, yes, there are athletes who are vegan, and that's another misconception that if you don't eat meat, then you're not healthy and you can't be an athlete and so on. And that is not true. Absolutely not.
So vegan, you could be very healthy. Like I said, absolutely. I've seen a lot of these athletes that are tip-top shape. And the reason why is the way they exercising is something that you have to always have in you. Eating good,
yeah.
No junk, this, that. Mm-hmm. And if you look at it, if you're vegan, it's a lot easier to say no to all those junk that we try to tell our kids, don't eat a lot of it, it's not mm-hmm. good for you, it's not good for you. But it tastes so damn good, man.
It's a matter of habit, again. It's a matter of habit.
www.theunclehood.com. You are listening to The Uncle Mike Show. We have Uncle Dirty Dirt in the southeast corner. And, of course, the bunch of mini-me's, because apparently they're getting offended if we don't mention the mini-me's. So yes, there are 6 mini-me's running around with Uncle Dirty, and we have the beautiful Tamar Panossian from 57cals.com. When you opened 57 Cals, what was the biggest hurdle that you thought you needed to overcome?
Just getting the word out about our restaurant. Like I was mentioning, we still to this day have customers who come in and are not used to the new menu and ask us why we changed the menu. So that was the biggest part, convincing the old customers that yes, our restaurant has changed menu, but it's still good and it's still something that we want you to try. And you were mentioning it before. Yes, we started as House of Falafel and introduced new ways of having falafel sandwiches with new sauces, new vegetables. And soon enough, we realized that, you know what, not everybody's going to have falafel every day. Not everybody likes falafel. So if we want to be a real vegan vegetarian restaurant, then we have to incorporate other types of sandwiches as well. So lately, we've come up with popular sandwiches that you as a vegan would probably not be able to find. So we have the shawarma, which is vegan, which you had. And
yes, and we didn't know. And before you continue, let me give a quick little story on that. Uncle Dirty was with me. We went to 57 Cals, take a couple of pictures for the sponsorship team that we're going to take over and try to build something for us. And we're looking around, and all of a sudden, Uncle Dirty got a phone call from the I team here in the Uncle Hood studio. On your way back, do you mind bringing us some food? Because we're a little bit hungry. Because we take advantage of Uncle Dirty like that. We always call him like our daddy. Daddy, I need a cell phone bill, please. Next thing you know, there's $112 exact money with the change and everything. But he never gives you that extra $2 for a coffee and shit. That's a little side, below the belt. So all of a sudden, we get the phone call. You know, we're hungry. Can you bring us a little something to the studio? So Uncle Dirty goes, yeah, no problem. I got this kick-ass shawarma sandwich, bro. And you got to know something. One of the IT team guys looks like he ate another 3 IT team guys. Because he's like about 400 plus. And he loves his sandwiches. He loves his food. And he's the type of guy you don't want to F with when it comes to his food, right? So I'm thinking, what the fuck is this guy doing? I go, so now they hang up the phone. He goes, oh, I'm going to get these guys so good. So he turns around to Tamar and goes, Tam, do me a favor. Give me 4 shawarma sandwiches to go. It was shawarma, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So now we have 4 shawarmas, but the beauty of beauty in this story is, it's not real shawarma. It's tofu based, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, they don't know that. So Uncle Dirty comes back to the studio like a tough guy, throws a couple of sandwiches left and right. Now these guys, like a bunch of pigs, open it up, chewing it down, couple of Pepsis, couple of cold ones, this, that. One is starting to burp already. Wow, what the best sandwich I've ever had. And Uncle Dirty, I could see, he's waiting for that right moment to come out with this secret that he's been keeping inside. Because I'll be honest, as soon as I realized that two, three of them took their bites, I told Harry, all right, guys, I'm out. Just let me know how it goes. If you need help, if you're in a hospital or whatever, just give me a call. I'll come for a visit. And then Uncle Dirty tells me, as soon as I told him that this was not meat, what you ate, and it was tofu, none of them knew it. All of them expected the sandwich to be a shawarma sandwich. So chapeau, because you guys have nailed it to the T.
Thank you. Bravo. Chapeau to my mom. She's the chef, so she's very creative. Yeah.
Bravo. Class A sandwich, man. So let's continue with that lineup. The first one you said was the shawarma.
Yeah, which, like you said, people don't believe that there's no meat in it. It's delicious. And the most recent is the Philly cheesesteak, which is another sandwich that vegans or vegetarians would usually not find anywhere. And we absolutely loved the sandwich back when we used to eat meat. So my mom was asking me, okay, Tamar, if you still ate meat, what was the one sandwich you would absolutely want to have? And my mom, the Philly sandwich. I have to have a Philly steak sandwich if I could. So she started trying to come up with different sauces for it, testing the tofu, how she could make it feel like it's a Philly cheese sandwich, and it is absolutely delicious. She has this avocado smoky sauce on it. Very, very good.
www.57cals.com. You could go to the website. They have all the pictures of all these meals, a little bit of explanation, what's inside, what's mm-hmm. not inside. But I was very curious. The name 57 Cals stands for 57 calories.
Uh-huh.
I heard that one ball of falafel is 57 cals. I tell my daughter, every day you have to learn something new.
Definitely.
I'm thinking today that's what it was right there. One ball of falafel, 57 calories, www.theunclehood.com. This is the Uncle Mike Show. We have 57 cals in studio, live and in person. If you had the choice to bring another... Oh, before I go to that question, let's stick to the menu.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't mention Uncle Mike's favorite dish at 57 Cals. Can you please elaborate a little bit on what I eat when I come to 57 Cals?
The salsa sandwich?
Is that a question? I go there once a week. I eat the same thing. Hi, Tanti. Can I have the same thing, please? Thank you. And she's asking me. The salsa.
The salsa sandwich is our falafel burrito. And although it's a falafel sandwich in itself, it's wrapped in a tortilla bread and it has a homemade salsa on it with guacamole sauce. So it's a big sandwich. And
personally, I love Mexican food. I go to Tri Amigos, Carlos and Pepe. Sometimes we go a little bit south to go to Taco Bell. I love Mexican food. And the burrito for me is one of my favorites. And the first time I took a bite of the burrito sandwich, again, the salsa falafel, which I thought was a fucking burrito. I take a bite. I tell my wife, babe, man, this burrito is... She goes, what burrito, man? It's falafel. I go, no, chicken arroz. I go, it can't be because it's really good.
Yeah.
He goes, well, that's what it is. But you guys put everything that goes good with it and it's unbelievable. That's my favorite sandwich. But when we mentioned that 57 Cals were coming in studio, of course, the email address is theunclemikeshow@gmail.com or at officialtoms on Instagram and Twitter or facebook.com/theunclemikeshow. We're going to get back to social media a little bit. I want to know what you think about it in a corporate industry, in the restaurant industry, and in the singing department. But before we get there, a couple of listeners, a couple of fans of 57 Cals want to know a little bit more about the story behind the Rafi Burger.
The Rafi Burger.
That is getting a lot of attention from us. We got about 4 emails, all of them referring to the Rafi Burger. So please elaborate a little bit. Where did it come from? Who came up with it? Is it good? What is it?
Okay, sure. So while we were still brainstorming on our new concept, our new menu, new restaurant, we were talking about it to our accountant, Rafi, who came up with the idea and said, you know what? It would be so delicious if you put a falafel in a hamburger bun, call it a falafel burger, and put the coleslaw on it and the ketchup on it. And we're like, well, we could give it a try. Why not? We tasted it and it was amazing. He tasted it, he loved it, and we were like, this is your signature sandwich, that's it. Rafi, this is your burger. So we called it Rafi Burger.
And that is ridiculous. How beautiful is that? Is yeah. there an opportunity to get a burger named the Dirty Dirt?
Absolutely.
All right, Uncle Hood, listen up very carefully. This is a little something we're going to put out there. Let's try to make this happen. If Uncle Dirty Dirt were to have a sandwich in a vegan restaurant, what type of dish would it be? Give us some recipes, some ideas. Let's see how far we could push this envelope, and imagine he gets his own sandwich. It's not enough. I was about to say, I'm getting in trouble, guys. Every time I get into his personal stuff, I'm getting in trouble, man. There are zeros missing from the check. My kid can't eat. My wife can't. It's a mayhem, man. It's a mayhem. So we got to stick to the stick to the basics, man. Stick to the basics. Tom, are you having a good time?
I am.
Yeah? Is this what you were expecting when you came on the Uncle Mike show?
I came in very nervous. But this is
and I told you, have to take it easy. I don't know why you're so nervous.
I don't know.
Usually, people, the first couple of minutes, and I'll be honest, like a trooper, the first couple of minutes, okay, you were a little bit the bug, but you got rid of it very easily, and the conversation started to flow. Uncle Dirty, I was about to go, it's on the Swatch watch, but as I walked into the studio, I realized that my watch is stopped at 1:45 on the 25th. So since then, I've been looking at my freaking time and telling people it's 1:45 whenever they've been asking me for the time. So, Uncle Dirty, what time is it right now? It's about 22 minutes past the hour. So this is the time to go pay some more bills, thanks to our great sponsorship team. I have to. This is called brownie points. You know, sugarcoating it. Thank you this, thank you that. Don't go nowhere, guys. The third and final segment of the Uncle Mike Show is coming up. A couple of key announcements. One monumental announcement. We're all going to break this in the third and final segment. Don't go too far. We'll be right back, baby, baby. Welcome back, baby. Welcome back. www.theunclehood.com. This is the Uncle Mike Show. We are live and streaming from coast to coast, LA to Chicago. Right now, we have 7 countries that have joined us. Thank you very much. Who the hell do we know in Budapest? I have absolutely no idea. It's either Uncle Dirty has a kid there and has absolutely no idea yet, or Budapest, thank you very much for standing up. Here in the third segment, we all know what we're about to do is reveal this week's Coast to Coast of the Week. The Coast to Coast, baby, right here. As you can see it, if you don't know, right here, you see it? Booyah, Coast to Coast, baby, right there. So how do you say that? We get approximately 3 to 5 submissions of a Coast to Coast from listeners, followers, fans, haters. Even the haters are starting to submit their Coast to Coast. And of course, in the third segment, we also have Tweet Me, Baby, One More Time. Oh yeah, baby. That's one of my favorite segments. And to put a sock into it, we go toe-to-toe with the lovely Tamar. The Can You 60 segment is imminent. Before we get there, how was your first experience on the Uncle Mike Show?
Very, very cool. This is fun. I could do this. I'm actually considering a talk show now.
Whoa! I love it! Julie, get ready. Competiciones coming to townes. www.unclehood.com is. Bro, I'll tell you, I could sing too. That was a rap right there.
I know, right? We should do it for sure.
Listen, okay. I said there is a monumental announcement. I'm going to make that the last minute. So you got to calm your horses, man. Calm your horses. Social media 2014 mm-hmm. is one of the biggest surroundings. Everybody's on it. Everybody talks about it. In the 57 Cal's industry, does it help it? It does not. If so, how? How do you guys use social media?
It helps for sure. I've tried the usual, you know, marketing with sending postcards to the homes and everything, but that doesn't work as well as social media in today's world. I have had such a big reach with Facebook. Love to use Facebook for my marketing. I don't just try to sell on Facebook. I post pictures. I keep it real. You know, there's a lot of people who post reviews on Facebook, which is a great help for restaurants. I love reading the reviews and commenting back with the customers.
You have so do that. You touch back with
absolutely.
The fans?
Absolutely. And I think that's the most important part of social media, to actually have a feel of what's on the field and what people think and how people feel and are you doing it right or wrong. So it's, we wouldn't be able to do it without social media for sure. So Facebook is one. Twitter, I'm still getting used to. I'm not too familiar with. Maybe you can coach me on Twitter. And Instagram, for those of you who are not following us on Instagram, you should, because we're going to be posting a contest soon on Instagram.
Nice. So. At 57 Cals at is 57 the domain Cals. On Twitter mm-hmm. And Instagram. And of course, 57 Cals on Facebook. facebook.com/57Cals. So now the first one we're going to embark on is going to be the coast to coast. I went on your timeline and I found one picture that you had absolutely no idea that you were pulling a coast to coast. And in our eyes, the ones that pull the coast to coast unwillingly are the true Unclehood members.
Okay.
Because we've all said it. Everyone has Unclehood in them. You just have to find it. And this one here, this week, the winner is none other than Celine Dion. Look at that coast to coast right there. You don't think she's giving a quick little shout out to us here in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, sitting in the Unclehood studio? Beautiful. The arms could be a little bit lower. The fingers are not quite visible, but the thought is what counts. Thank you very much, Madame Celine Dion. Et un petit message pour vous, ma belle. T'as plein de billions de dollars dans le banque, calice de tabarnak. On va amener les expos ici. Tu vas faire deux shows pendant l'année. Tu vas faire le sold out. Puis that's all, man. Tu veux-tu que je dirige cette nouvelle tragédie? Mal faire, man. Donne-nous un quick shout-out. The Uncle Mike Show at gmail.com. A little message to Celine Dion. If anybody knows Celine Dion, make sure she listens to the last 5 minutes of the program. We have a quick little message for her. All right, we got the coast to coast. Not bad. Celine Dion stepping in. Coast to coast. Thank you very much. Now we go straight to Tweet Me Baby one more time. What is Tweet Me Baby? The entire iTeam on a weekly basis gets on Twitter and just scopes around. Unclehood members, strangers, celebrities, CEOs, name it. The only things we try to stay away from are politicians and lawyers. Why am I mentioning politicians and lawyers? I'll get to it very, very shortly, guys. I still can't believe we're about to have that type of program, but yes, we are. Hold on. Give me 1 second. The first one we're going to, Uncle Dirty Dirt, is from Zach. Is that the one we're going to? At Cheeseburger Tweets. Just had a 20-minute argument with my mom if my hairstylist should trim my beard. Hashtag fear the beard. As you notice, Uncle Hood, a few months ago, the pressure... No, let me rephrase that. My entire family ambushed me and did a intervention. I walked in to my mother, mother-in-law, aunt, niece, cousin from a third mother that I didn't even know existed. And they all of a sudden started bashing my freaking beard. When are you going to take it off? We got to call you Muhammad. Guys, it's trimmed. It's nice. It's clean. It's not. But the pressure got to me and I had to put the trimmer to it. Zach, my man, from me to you. A real man shaves like this. He doesn't shave. He's got a freaking beard. That's how we roll. Hashtag fear the beard. Zach, my man, we got your back. And I'm telling you from now, mom, mother-in-law, wife, daughter, cousin, niece, nephew. You see it? It's growing. That's all I'm saying. Because if you guys put too much pressure, it's going to come back off. You know it. I know it. But for now, I just got to act tough, baby. Baby. The second tweet we go to is check yourself. Okay, whoa, 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 whoa. First of all, I love the name. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. At before ya wreck yourself. This the season to be la, 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 la. Hashtag yoga pants. Booyah, baby. Can I ask you a question? How many pairs of yoga pants do you own?
Like three.
That's a good number. It's an average number. I think you gotta have 30. That's the right number. You gotta be swimming in them. You gotta be sleeping in them. Yoga pants for everyone. Check yourself. Thank you very much. I love this tweet. This the season. Because if you look at it, it's still too hot for jeans and pants, but yet too cold for shorts. Mm-hmm. This the season, baby, baby. Hashtag yoga pants, the yoga pants. And the last but not least tweet of the week. We had to keep it related with the program. So what do? Hashtag falafel. This one here was found by Bridget. It's the third mini-me in the southeast corner. She's got one eye closed. You can't look at her in the eye too much. Goodness. But she's okay. She's a very good girl. Bridget, I love you, sweetheart. Just stay on that side of the freaking studio. Now, the tweet that we wanted to find was hashtag falafel. And we found an amazing one coming in from Couscous Foods. And the tweet reads as follows. Who would you give your last falafel to? Hashtag falafel. Now, that question I ask you, my dear Tamar,
that is,
if you had one falafel to give away, mm-hmm. who would you give it to?
That is a very, very hard question.
I'm going to ask Uncle Dirty now after this. Let's see what he says.
Actually, because we need him to edit this video, I think we'll give it to him.
So you're giving yours to Uncle Dirty?
I'm giving it to Uncle Dirty.
Uncle Dirty gets the first falafel that is the being handed out. Uncle Dirty, if you had one falafel to give away, who would you give that falafel to?
I'm going to give it to Tamar.
Aww, heck yes.
Guys, okay. I'm going to leave the studio for a couple of minutes. I don't know what's going on over here. Maybe they're even playing footsie under the table. I have no idea. But they're giving each other falafels. When they came in, they high-five each other. Me, I'm standing here like this. And if you guys don't believe me, watch the first 2 minutes of the program. I was like this. Guys, I can't. Please. And they're looking at each other and like winking and stuff. Everybody that comes into the studio as my guests, so I'm thinking they're my friends, they're buddy-buddy with the Southeast Corner.
Of course.
And they ask me, what was your name again? What the fuck is going on, man? www.theunclehood.com. This is it, baby. This is it. It's getting crunch time. We are 7 minutes past the hour. And the only reason Uncle Dirty hasn't blown a casket is because we're having an unbelievable time. Hopefully you sitting at home from coast to coast, LA to Chicago, are having as good as a time as we are. Now what we're going to do, Tam, is very easy.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to give Uncle Dirty the opportunity to put a little bit of a beat so everybody at home could loosen up.
Mm-hmm.
Most importantly, you loosen up, sweetheart.
Okay.
Because, yes, I've been smiling, I've been funny, and all this is now put inside of a nice little box, hidden inside of a treasure casket and thrown in the deepest of the abyss. Uncle Dirty, hit that shit. Baby, giddy up! The Can You 60 segment is right here in front of us. If you're new to the Unclehood movement, Very simple, Uncle Dirty Put, 60 seconds. I have a list of questions. Sometimes I read them, sometimes I don't. Sometimes it's funnier, sometimes they're not. But the most important thing is, Tamar has absolutely no idea what these questions are and what these questions are about. So now let's see how many she can answer and how truthfully she can answer. So all her family at home listening, friends, family, associates, if you hear an answer and it's wrong, theunclemikeshow@gmail.com. You could submit it. Uncle Dirty will love to take that and put Uncle Auntie Tamar uncle. In front of the bus. I've called all my aunties Uncle Man. It's not my fault. It's just this unclehood thing. It's just tattooed in my brain. Uncle Dirty, 60 seconds on the clock, please.
Yikes.
All right. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. What's your name?
Tamar.
How old are you?
29.
How tall are you?
5'2".
What would you do if you won the lottery?
Donate.
Can you juggle?
No.
Are you a good listener?
Yes.
Are you a good dresser?
Yes.
Are you a good skier?
No.
Are you a good lover?
Yes.
Are you a good comedian?
Sometimes.
What was your favorite holiday?
Halloween.
What's your favorite radio show?
Uncle Hood.
C'est comme ça que ça se fait, Madame Mary Pearl. Okay, Mix 96. What's your favorite TV program?
Don't have one.
Do you want children?
Absolutely.
Do you have any children?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Do you like reality TV programs?
Sometimes.
Have you ever played a practical joke on anyone?
Yes.
Have you ever flown a kite?
No.
How long can you balance on one foot?
I don't know.
Do you have any scars?
Yes.
Have you ever been to jail?
No.
Have you ever stabbed anyone?
No.
If you were a superhero, what would be your name?
Super Tamar.
Super Tamar in the house! Very good, not bad. I felt a little bit of tension. I felt a little bit of anxiety. I was like, fuck, should I continue asking questions? At a point, I thought she was going to faint, man. Are you okay?
I'm great.
Yeah, baby. Uncle Dirty is right now tallying up the score. Not bad at all. Average in studio, male, female, women, child, animal, doesn't matter, species, creature is 25. And she got 25 for that, Tamar. Bravo, man. Bravo.
Thank you.
Now what we're going to do, Uncle Dirty, I need you to put put Auntie Tamar on big screen. You see how beautifully he does that? Zoop, zoop, two buttons, zoop, zoop. This is it, man.
That's
on back of the glass, there's only one guy that could make sure we're smooth sailing. Uncle Dirty Dirt. Why Dirty Dirt? Oh my God, that's a... Forget about one show. That's like a multiple shows put together. We make it into a series and then season 1, season 2, season 3, season 4. How long do we go? We don't know. Tamar, very simple. This is the camera that you will be looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Coast to coast, everybody is looking at you.
Mm-hmm.
If there is any thank yous that you need to do, this is the time to do it. We call them shout-outs or brownie points. If you want to get
brownie
them, go
points.
Ahead.
Absolutely. Well, before I say my thank yous, I want to say that in staying true to our concept of serving fresh foods, because we make new falafels every hour, whatever is extra in the after that hour, we freeze and we donate. So that's our part of giving back. And we have the association called Agape who comes and picks it up and gives it to families who need. Thank you. Aside from that, I want to thank everybody who makes it possible for my job to be easy. So my employees at Allagma Technologies, my employees at 57 Cals, our employees are our assets, and we wouldn't be able to do anything without our employees. So big shout out to them. Very special thank you to my uncle, who is both my boss, my mentor, and someone I look up to, who has given me so many chances in my life and who I learn from on a daily basis. Thank you. And to my mom, who is very patient with me, and to my family and friends. And you guys for inviting me today. This has been very special.
Thank you very much for coming in studio. Like I said, when we wanted to go in the corporate avenue, we wanted to get a beautiful lady. There was nobody else that jumped in our head. We said Tamar from 57 Cals would do the job. And between Uncle Dirty, myself, and the millions watching at home, you did a fabulous
Thank
job.
You.
You were a natural. And when you said you're thinking of a new a new endeavor, maybe a new radio show. Why not? You have the charisma, you have the beautiful face, you have the articulation. So all that together, you'll make a great guest. Thank I'm you. Still lacking two of the three. What am I still doing here after 2.5 years? I have no fucking idea. But it's because of our very loyal listener group that we have from coast to coast on a daily basis that get in and allow us to do what we love to do.
Yeah.
And I've always said it, the Uncle Mike Show would be a great show if we have great guests. And every single one of my guests have made my job so much easier. And for that, I am truly grateful. So now tonight's program is in the books, but there's a lot more of Tom's Women's Month on Tom's coming up. The next one on the hit list, I can't believe this, but we're going in the politics route. We have Sona Lahoyan coming in the studio. Why is this important in my opinion? A, we're going to be talking about the education here in Quebec, who she happens to be one of the commissioners at the Laval school board. She's running for higher echelons, and we want to know exactly how we can help her, the community. And it's us, the new generation, that needs to think of our kids' future when it comes to education. And if we have the opportunity to get someone as talented, as humble as Sona Lahoyan to come in studio, we did not miss the opportunity. We didn't have any Wednesdays left, but Uncle Dirty and my gorgeous wife made sure they pulled the plugs. And the 13th of October, which is a Monday at 7:30 p.m., we have Sona Lahoyan coming in studio. On Wednesday's edition of the Uncle Mike Show, a part of WMP, we have S.M. Avoca. Uncle Dirty told me we have lawyers coming to town. I told them, who sued us? He goes, no, you fucking idiot. They're your guests. Thank you very much for the two beautiful girls that are about to come on our program. And I can't wait. The type of questions that I'm going to be asking lawyers, it's going to be one for the books. So Uncle Hood, get ready. S.M. Avoca are coming in studio, and that one there, you don't want to miss it. The week after that, on the 23rd, the Thursday edition of the Uncle Mike Show, we have Rita Jade, our life coach. Imagine having a life coach right here that we could pick her brain. If you have any questions, Uncle Hood, this is the time to submit them. And you don't even need to wait for that week. Send them now. Uncle Dirty and the Southeast Corner is going to make sure that all the emails are tallied up, and during the program, each and every one of them will be read and hopefully answered on or off the air. I told everybody that we have a monumental announcement to make. Uncle Hood Studio is about to embark on a one-year production of a making of a boxer. Someone that has absolutely no boxing background is about to step in the ring and learn the trade from the beginning all the way to its first amateur bout that will take place November or December 2015. Now, you might be wondering, who is this soul, this young Thundercat that is going to step in the ring? Well, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great honor to announce that I will be taking my talents from back of this beautiful red marble table to inside of the squared circle. Who will be coaching us? The Grant Brothers Boxing Gym, in association with the DiBella Kickboxing Gym. So as you can see, I got the right people teaching me the ropes. Now let's see if I have the will to conduct myself as a professional and do everything that the coaches ask me to do. If I don't, very simply, I will lose my bout next December. If you think I'm going to work 1 year, put my entire reputation on the line, and go out to lose, everybody has something else coming. Get ready, Uncle Hood. There's a lot more announcement about this project to come out through our social media outlets. Be patient, but get ready. This is going to be very interesting, And Uncle Dirty has a lot of secrets that he's not divulging to me. Why? When it comes to the sparring sessions, apparently he's already gotten half a dozen people that want to step in the ring with me for a sparring session. Could that be Uncle John Kakulakis, host of the John K Show, following our program tonight at 9:30 here on www.theunclehood.com? Could one of those combatants be my wife? If that's one of them, I don't even know if I want to continue with this project. But whatever Uncle Hood has planned, I know bottom line is for you, the end user, the ones sitting at home on the couch in front of your tablet, computer, or your smartphone. Without you, none of this would be possible. And it's for you that we continuously do what we do in this studio. Original live broadcast on a daily basis. From the Julie Talk Live every Thursday night at 10:30 p.m. to the Blackout every Thursday night at 7 p.m. to the Uncle Mike Show every Wednesday night at 7:30 p.m. and the ones that put a sock into it, the John K Show with John Kakulakis and his sidekick, Uncle Stevie V. Now that everything is said and done, there's only one way we end our program, and it's got to do with the index fingers, baby. From coast to coast, LA to Chicago, Uncle Hood and 57 Cals are